Till I relay this dreadful news, it's worth your while to stand. Concerning the poor passengers from Liverpool sailed away. On board the ship, the hero to them a welcome day. It was in the month of January, all in this present year. We steered a course for Sydney, the weather it being fair. When parting from old Erin's shore, we bid our friends goodbye. It's in the deep we lie. We were not far from Liverpool when heavy gales did blow. For 13 days our gallant ship was tossing to and fro. But on the morning of the 6th, most dreadful for to hear, our vessel struck against a rock which filled our hearts with tears. It would make the hardest heart to grieve to hear the bitter cries of the children and their mother, the husbands and their wives. Now, alas, what shall we do? The ocean is our grave. It was our sad misfortune, our home and friends to leave. As for our noble captain, the truth for you I'll tell. He treated us most tenderly and did his duty well. Likewise, our gallant seamen, their exertions proved in vain. Our gallant ship in pieces went on the raging main. They then launched out their small boat upon the ocean wide, for the children, for their parents, so bitterly they cried. But to our great misfortune, as you may understand, the boats they sunk beneath the waves and could not reach the land. Some of those poor passengers remained upon the deck. And when our ship in pieces went, they floated on the wreck. Some rocks then being convenient, it's on them they decreed. While 220 young and old were buried in the deep. For 2 long days and 2 long nights, the truth I will explain. We had to stop upon this rock under wind and heavy rain, thinking on the friends we lost, for to increase our grief. When the ship arose above them, or down to our relief. So to conclude these feeling lines, I have no more to say. We lost 220 souls in a deep and dismal sea. Oh, Holy Mary, pray. grant a friend here.